Welcome back. Now, Johannesburg will be in the national and international spotlight.
Not the BVN that you saw.
No, not the BVN.
Yeah.
We'll be in the spotlight as it welcomes over 5,000 delegates and visitors from across the continent and beyond who have keen interest in issues of African local government. Now, African local government. Well, okay, we'll hear more about this. We have in the studios this morning the Secretary General of the United Cities and Local Government for Africa, Mr. Jean-Pierre Along Mbassi. Thank you so much for being here this morning.
Thank you.
We also have the Friend of UCLGA and Urbanization and Decentralization Experts, Professor Johnson Faladi. Thank you for coming on this morning.
Thank you very much.
Let me ask Mr. Mbassi. What is the coming together of African local governments?
Well, it's the coming together of Africa, because everyone belongs to a local government. And this is where people feel that they exist, their identity, and this is where they want to have the improvements of their living conditions of their lives. So, coming together to celebrate the local Africa means celebrating the peoples of Africa. And we want that this gathering in Johannesburg is seen as a new beginning for Africa. This AfriCities 2015 is happening in a moment when the African Union is proposing to foresee the Africa we want, Agenda 2063.
I was going to ask them.
2063.
Yeah. What is AfriCities going to do differently than what African Union is doing?
I don't know if you read the theme, the topic of this conference. It says
shaping the future of Africa
with the people. Remember, the African Union has been perceived for many, many years as a club of head of states. And what they are discussing up there does not filter so much down to the ground where the people are living. And the feeling of many Africans are that this institution that represents the voice of Africa is not so much connected to the African people. We, as local authorities, local government, we are proposing this connection. We are the missing link, and we want to bring the people on board. We cannot imagine the future of this continent only among national governments. You need the people. And this is why at AfriCities, we invited in Johannesburg 18 key stakeholders to bring their inputs into the Agenda 2063 so that it become owned by the African people.
Okay.
And then can be implemented.
Let's go to Professor Faladi. Indeed, the local government is said to be the closest to the people, but yet you see not so much development at that level. What exactly are those things you'll be focusing on at the summit's coming?
Well, I think as Jean-Pierre has said, local governments are the governments that have been marginalized over the years, and they have to come up. And I think the greatest enemies that local governments have are the central and the regional government that tend to suppress them in as much as possible. If you talk to some governors now in this country or all over the place, you're going to find a situation where they don't believe in the existence of local government. They say there's no capacity there. And that's the explanation. But no capacity there is not a substitute for not having them. It is the government closest to the people that when things are not working, you can walk in there, give a knock at the door, and ask and demand for services to be done. But it's not happening at the moment because we are not focusing on it. And let me just tell you one fact, that the only way national government came into being is because we had destroyed governance at city level, and at that level, that's why colonization came into being in the first place. Before colonization, you had powerful empires that were run on city-states. Now, they have to destabilize and dismantle those to get national government. And so everything became increasingly centralized, or even over-centralized over the years, that we are now saying, let us raise power from the center to the local levels. So local governments could function in this country if we want to make them function. If you invest in local government and put human resources there, then we can wipe away millions of unemployment in this country.
All right, so Prof, tell us then, because I mean, when people hear that you want to involve Africa local authorities to ensure that African Union to fulfill this vision, they already will remember their different countries, the challenge they have, local governments developing, let alone come to Africa, which is a bigger picture. So where are we? Where is AfriCity in this quest?
Well, AfriCity is a worthy partner. And the reason why they came up is the fact that there are no voices for local governments. And they want a situation where local governments could have a voice. Let me give you an example. We have set up ALGON to champion the cause of local government in this country. Yes, they are existing on paper, but they could do more. They're not doing it. We have several areas where local governments have been marginalized. Resources are coming from the center. It doesn't reach local government. We have it in constitution that elections should be conducted every 2 years for local government. Most governors are running their apparatus without conducting any election. So they appoint supervisory councillors who are their own stooges. So people don't elect these people as it has been mandated in the law. So we have a situation where at local government level, I would say it is not government of the people, by the people, for the people, but government of people who are higher up, wanting their own positions to be really elongated and
is sustained. Is this what AfriCity's plan to change?
AfriCity is now a voice galvanizing these various national entities. And when the EU says something about 2063 of African Union agenda, there's no way Nigeria can implement Vision 2020 without involving the local government. There's no way any national government can function without their local government. There's no way African Union can function without the constituent governments in each of those countries, as well as because until all the global MDGs can be translated on the streets and people will understand them, that's when we begin to say development is people-centered and people-oriented.
Indeed, AfriCity, you've got a long-term kind of agenda that you want to. Tell us about the 2063 agenda. What are you planning to achieve by that time?
Well, it's not me. It's our leadership on the continent that says we want a different Africa. The Africa we want is an Africa with peace, is an Africa with development, is an Africa which is inclusive, which fight against poverty, which is pushes the solidarity principle of Africans. This we claim to be to live in solidarity and so on.